building alliances, this is not to be confused with building bridges. Building bridges is a different initiative. By building alliances, we're talking about warming up for 2022. This is one of the big stories on the front page of the Daily Nation. And there's a picture there of different players that could potentially be involved in whoever will become president come 2022, from the deputy president, NASA leader Raila Odinga, Joho, Wetangula, Honorable Musalia Mudavadi, Kalonzo, Honorable Gideon Moi, Honorable Amason Kingi, the governor, as just to name a few. And they're all in a circle, in a sense, because everyone's trying to talk to everybody else in the build-up to 2022. One or two paragraphs here just for your indulgence. Officially, the country is 4 years away from the next election. Unofficially, however, the campaigns have started, meaning you should prepare for another long and nasty season of campaigns. Can you imagine, barely a few months after the campaigns for last year were wrapped up? While the deputy president forays across the country are well documented, his political rivals are getting off the blocks after realizing a bit late that he may have jumped the gun. Which is why it is least surprising that the opposition, which was caught napping in the run-up to 2017, is already forging new and wider alliances. And if you want that story, you can go to page 4 of the Daily Nation. And of course, page 5 of the Daily Nation has a story about Coast opposition leaders vow to back 2022 Ruto presidency. Now, all this happening as all the leaders have told Kenyans that it's time for politics to be set aside. Let's talk about development. But you can see that they are saying one thing and doing something completely different. Honorable Loach, let me start with you. I don't know whether you're also in the campaign mood. Maybe we can start there before you give us your thoughts.
I think you're always in the campaign mood. And in as much as we want to tell Kenyans, you know, stop politicking and focus on 2022, you realize that the more the more things change, the more they will remain the same. Ruto will say with one end of the lip that, you know, Mambo ya 2022 achaneni nayo, and he appears to be reading on the same script with the president, but then lined up all these people behind him, which I mean, saying basically that you see 2022, the vehicle is and the place to be is in William Samoei Ruto's camp. One of the people was saying in the Coast province that ni kama samaki na maji. And you know, I think I don't know whether to read politics of development. People have reached that mode of the Moi era, where in order to be able to get the goodies, you have to look where the bread is buttered. And at the moment, we have to admit it, the deputy president is the one who seems to have
the
knife and the yam. For some reason, the president is quote-unquote focusing on the legacy, but the instruments of power, the launching of projects, the allocation of who's going to do what, seems to be left to the deputy president. And I think people who are looking at smart money are saying, well, 2022 alliances and all these gentlemen around here, we will see how the wave goes. But at the moment, the deputy president who seems to have the purse strings, and I think that's why you're seeing people falling over themselves, people from especially Coast region for some reason. He seems to be focusing in Kilifi and in Kwale. And it's all about people trying to get goodies. And second issue, I think, is that people seems to be saying, position yourself in the inner circle of the front runner ahead of everybody else. But things will change. I think look out for the body language between three sets of people here. I'm not dismissing some, but I think look out for what happens between...
So it's a three-horse race.
Yeah. What happens between Raila, Gideon, and Kalonzo? Watch out on how things work out around there, because a lot of dynamics may change. But I think the more we tell people focus on 2022, I mean focus on development, and 2022 will sort out itself, the more you're getting them into that particular pit. Yeah.
You seem to have given us a bit of a hint there, secretly. Honorable Nyoro, what's your? Let's also get your hint.
I think we are genuine when we, especially on our side or in government, when we say that we are focusing on development. And sometimes I get perturbed when I get my colleague and other Kenyans reading like there is any divisions between Jubilee, in terms of there is one pulling around legacy and another one doing other things. Because clearly we have one presidency, we have the same leadership, but then they are complementary. as the president is going out there to look possibly for investors and to look for goodies from out there, we also need someone who is down there in Mashinani checking on how that money is being spent.
In fact, the president used a particular phrase to describe
tanga.
Tanga. I think that is the word. We are out there, including myself, even him and him, we are really actually in parliament. We are always tagatagaying in our constituencies because even as we get money for our constituencies, even as we vouch for development to come to our constituencies, we also have an obligation as leaders to look at how this money is being spent, but number two, also to listen to the people. Because many times we get governments that do development for the sake of development. It is always good to do development that is demand-driven from the people themselves. And I think that is what the deputy president has been focusing on. We support him. We've been with him on the trail because that is the right thing to do.
There are two dangers that I would want to bring to your attention even as you carry on. Number one, what does this do for the governors? Remember, the focus was supposed to move from national government to county. But the message that we are seeing is that when the deputy president visits your area, things are going to change. What does that do for the governors who are actually supposed to be the people that are looked up to? Secondly, in terms of a development agenda, if you go to a place and the people are crying, give us good roads, and yet that was not part of the agenda maybe was health or food security, what then happens with that? Because you now have the same budget funding additional projects that were not part of the original plan. Because that's what's going to happen. If the deputy president comes to my home, I'm going to tell him I want this, and yet maybe the government's overarching plan was different. How do you then balance all those interests?
The spirit of devolution is that clearly there are some roles that are clearly vested on the national government. That is the executive in terms of the national executive and us as members of parliament. There is also the other layer of the governors, senators, and MCAs, that is the county governments. Therefore, when we get probably the deputy president going to launch, for example, a road, a tarmac road, that is being built by Kera or Kura or Kenha, clearly those are national government entities, and he has a right to do that. But also, going to Mashinani and getting people asking what they need, that is part of public participation, clearly. Because as a leader, for example, myself, when I go to a church in Kiharu, when I go for a function in Kiharu, in a far-flung village, that is when I actually clearly understand that I was planning to give them electricity. What they need more urgently is water. Without doing that, that is the leadership by walking around. Leadership by walking around, you are able to identify the clear needs that the people need so that you can allocate, not you borrow money to allocate to these new projects. We have only one budget, but to clearly reallocate money and plan the national cake.
So reallocation is the word.
Reallocation is the word, and also sharing the national cake to where it matters most.
Honorable Manzo.
Yes, first of all, I want to say that the building alliances is very much related to the building of bridges. And the fact that there was a handshake, it's big politics for 2022. And without alliances in this country, no single candidate is able to get anywhere by his region or tribe. And therefore, alliances are important so that we could have a strong nation and have strong competition in the next elections. Therefore, I want to agree that though it seems the deputy president is already on a campaign mode and is moving around the country to launch projects, these projects are first and foremost budgeted. Budget is a tool of the executive. And it should be distributed evenly and fairly across the country. It's debated by parliament, is approved by parliament, passed by parliament. Therefore, there's no chance of reallocation of budget. We should plan a year before and execute the developments which have been planned. But I want to say that we are yet to see alliances. I want to agree with the Honorable Lodge between, the Honorable Gideon Moi, the Honorable Kalonzo Musyoka, the Honorable Raila Odinga, and others who are going to join them. We are looking forward into competitive politics and the strong alliances so that we can have better leadership in the country.
Do you agree with that sort of development model that Honorable Nyoro says is more people-driven, people-centered, you know, get real? Is that how you also do your campaigns?
Public participation has already been done by budget committee. So there's no more public participation to be done. You already know you have already have a plan. You know, CDF is already planned. Do you know what you are going to do in the next 1 year or so?
So this other model you disagree with?
That model I don't agree with. It is just an effort to make early campaigns, and soon Kenyans will make a decision. I like the position of President Uhuru Kenyatta that let's work now, we'll deal with the politics later.
Let's work now, we deal with politics. I want you to allow me to take a very short break. This is not a topic we're going to finish in the next 5 minutes. I need to take this break. Before I do, however,